Everyone have your Bible? Or you left it at home? Can I see the Bibles? I love to see the Bibles. Even in my Sunday class, I bother them to bring the Bible. So can I see Bibles? All right, good. Thank you. Please turn your Bible to Luke chapter 15. Please turn your Bible to Luke chapter 15. Title of my message is Earthly Story in Heavenly Meaning. Earthly Story in Heavenly Meaning. Title of my message is Earthly Story in Heavenly Meaning. What does parable mean? Luke chapter 15 is all about parables. God is talking to his disciples with parables. Parable means earthly story in heavenly meaning. We're going to go in detail to see. Can somebody read Luke chapter 15 verse 1 to 6 loud, please?
Then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners for who were here. The Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, this man is seeing sinners and eating with them. And spoke this parable unto them, saying, what man of you, having an hundred sheep, you lose one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness, and go after that which is lost, so he might. And when he had found it, he laid it on his shoulder, joyfully. And when he comes home, he called together his friends, and he was saying unto them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which is lost.
God is saying, like, he lost one sheep out of 100. How many of you can say the percentage? 1 out of 100. 1%, right? So even the 1%, God cares. And he was going after that lost sheep, and he wanted to find. When he found, he put that sheep on his shoulder and he rejoiced. So that's the God we serve. Let's turn to Matthew chapter 18, verse 11. I will read it for you. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost. His main purpose to come to this earth, to save the lost. So you might be asking, who is that lost? Before we came to know the Lord, we were lost. And he came to save us. And when he took us, we came to him. Actually, he was coming after us. We didn't go after him. First, he came after us. He took us and he put us on his shoulder and he was rejoicing. So the second part of the parable, we read Luke chapter 15, verse 8 to 10. There's three parables. The first parable, he came to us. The second parable, can read? 15, 8 to 10.
I know that. What woman having 10 pieces of silver, if she lost one piece, doth not a light candle, and seek the house, and seek diligently till she finds it. And when she has found it, she calls her friends and her neighbors together, saying, rejoice with me, for I have found the piece which I had lost. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repents.
Okay, the second parable talks about a woman. If you read it in Tamil Bible, it's talked about, in Tamil it says it's three, which is, it represents the church. So God brought us from outside, carried us, and he put us in the church. So the woman represents the church, which is us, you and I, right? When we lose something in the church, after we come to church, also sometimes we lose some stuff. How many of you agree? You have everything when you got first time, like you are 100% righteous. Is anybody there? Please raise your hands and wave at me. I want to see. None. So sometimes if we come to church, still we lose something. So what God did is, he still expects us to search every day when we come to church. When you come to church, come with the prayerful mind. Don't come sit here and talk to your friends, or chatting on the phone, or sometimes you say, I'm checking the Bible on the phone, but there's a message pop up, and you answer that. So then you won't be able to search. I can testify every day when I come, God speaks to us. Many times he corrects me. Sometimes I get a slump. Sometimes I get a knock on my head. So when you receive it and change, so you will go to glory and glory. I encourage you guys to come to Tuesday Bible studies. Pastor preach in both language, so you never get those things. Those are gems. I remember I went to Bible study somewhere. You have to pay for your books. You have to pay for your tunes. You have to pay for the class. But we are getting it free, and we are getting better than what I got. So I'm testifying in front of you. If you can make a time, 2 hours on Tuesdays, please come. So you search your heart every day with the word of God, and you go from glory to glory. So another word I can say, when you fall from the previous state, you're sitting here, then the word of God comes every week in a different way. So don't go like it's not for me or that person. And you might know them personally, then you think like it's coming to them. So you receive it. You say, God, I receive this word, and you try to change. If you say, I never fall down after I came to God, I'm always okay, glory to God, and then what will happen, next parable will say what will happen to those people. So if you fall from the previous state where you were, humble yourself. Sometimes pastor or somebody preaching here, they give altar call. People check next person whether what they're going to think before they make a move. So sometimes God expects us to take a one step further and come to the pulpit, front of the pulpit, kneel down, altar, not to the pulpit, to the altar, and kneel down and expects us to tell him how we feel. So from there, God will take you to the next level. Okay, let's read like the next parable. From verse 11. So if you don't follow the second parable after you come to church, and if you don't clear every week when you come, repent and search yourself and move on with your life, this is will happen from the verse 11. I will read it. And he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. This is the second parable. Okay, first parable, 1 is to 100, which is 1%, percentage. Second parable is 1 is to 10, which is a 10%. Now God is going into the 50%. 1 is to 2. The second parable, he's saying he had two sons. The younger one told the father, give me everything. Divide me my portion, properties, money, bank account. Give me half. I'm going to go away. So he decided to go far away from the father. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. So what he did, he took everything and he wanted to live the way he wanted to live. So why he came to this state? He was sitting in the church and he didn't check with the word of God coming to him. He didn't receive it. So he fell into the state to go even further. So when he went further, and what happened, and not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. He lost everything. Whatever he had, all the hope was lost, all the money was lost, everything was lost. And after that, verse 15, it says, and he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into his fields to feed swine. So what happened, like, sometimes we go to school, go to work, sometimes we think like, oh, we have to be among the unbelievers. So good news is you have to be among the unbelievers. Bad news is, are you winning them? Are you winning them, or are you influencing them? Or they influencing you? There's a two category. You shouldn't run away from the unbelievers. You have to have, sometimes you have to spend with them, but you don't follow them. You don't follow what they do. So God expects you to bring them to church. If you don't talk to them, they can't come. But are you influencing them? Or are you just trying to be nice to them? And you think like what they will think about me if I don't do whatever they ask. So he went into join himself with the citizen of that country. So which citizen are we? What kind of citizen we hold? Canadian citizen or heavenly citizen? So when we come out of heavenly citizen and we go into walk into another country, this worldly system, worldly citizen, so we lose everything. So and he sent him into the his fields to feed swine. That's the bad thing. Swine will eat everything. You know, swine is another word, pig. Pig will eat everything. He's whatever he sees. Whatever he, it's nasty things also eat. I don't want to say it. We know back home we see what pig will stay in the mud, roll in the mud, and he makes all the dirty things. So he eats everything. So he started to work in the field where the pigs are. And he would fain have filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat. Imagine he had everything good with father and he ended up eating what swine eat. And no than gave unto him. And nothing gave unto him, so he started to eat what pigs eat. This is what happened. When we run away from God, we will start to eat. It's not specifically talks about the food pigs eat. It's whatever the worldly people do. You might party, you might drink, you might do smoking and drugs, and you might go to clubs, and you might lose your salvation. So in order to keep your salvation, you have to be in the heavenly citizen. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my fathers have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. So when you go very far from the Lord, it's good if you come back to your sense. So what happened? He lost the sonship. So all the things he had, he lost it. And then if you read from Luke 15, 1 to 6, our daddy Jesus searched us and he found us and he brought us to church and he kept us. So you were clean. The second part, he's giving the word to clean you more and more and more. Every day he cleanses us. The third part, he's waiting for us to come back. So he, in order to come back, first thing, you have to go through the door of grace. It's waiting for you. Before the door of grace closes, we have to walk through it. So let's read Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 38. Somebody else take Isaiah chapter 30, verse 2 and 3. Isaiah chapter 30, verse 2 and 3. Can somebody read Hebrews 10, 38?
Now the just shall live by faith, but if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in it.
God says, just shall live by faith. Isaiah 30, 2 and 3.
Who go down to Egypt without consulting me, who look for help to Pharaoh's protection, to Egypt's shade for refuge. But Pharaoh's protection will be to your shame. Egypt's shade will bring you disgrace.
So when we walk back to Egypt, we will be disgraced. So he lost his father's love, first of all. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 18. Can somebody read? Ephesians 3, verse 18. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 18.
May he be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth and length and depth and height.
So God is saying, like, you have to see his love. The way he's saying breadth. I ask God, what is the meaning of the breadth? Anything you do, still he loves you. When you repent and come to him, the first love he still will give to you. That is the breadth love. The length, I ask, until the eternity. That's the length his love will be. He will love you until the eternity. And the next one is the depth. Even when you were in the pit, you might think nobody can reach you. He will still reach to you, to the pit, and he will take you out. The height. Ask God, what does the height mean? Like he said, up to heaven. Can you reach to heaven? No. Up to heaven, he reaches you. So you will understand when you read this verse. Breadth is anything you've done, you ask forgiveness. That doesn't mean you have a guarantee and license to do wrong thing. But you repent, fully repent, God will take you back and give you the same love. And the length is up to eternity. And the depth is when you are in the pit, he will reach down. You might think like nobody can see you, but God sees you wherever you are. And the height is up to heaven. If you know this, you will never doubt him. First, he lost his father's love. The second one, he lost his status. The status was he had everything good. He had half of the property. He had a money and everything. So he lost. So according to the Bible, it talks in the parable. But when I meditate, God said, everything, every word in the Bible belongs to you and I. So if we go far, we lost, we become guilty, and we don't know what we are thinking, right? So he started to lose his status, like sonship. Proverbs 27:8. Can you read Proverbs 27:8?
As a bird that wanders from her nest, so is a man that wanders from his place.
Yeah. The way the bird wandereth from the nest. If we go away from God, we will wander in our way. So we have to be very careful when we come to the presence of God. We come with trembling and say, God, speak to me. And wherever I need to change. And then he lost his father's love. Second, he lost his status. Then he lost his property and goods. But I have a good news for you. When you turn back to God today, he will give it to you, whatever you lost. You might be saying, like, what are you talking about? I come to church every day. I come and I raise my hands and worship God. We see you raising the hands and worshiping the Lord. But only God sees your status. How far are you from God? He knows. When God's word comes to you, open your heart, then he will do the surgery. So if you come back to him today, he wanted to take you where you lost your identity. We are going to see the younger son, what he did, then we can follow. So verse Luke chapter 15. Let's read it. Verse 17, it talks about, and when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. He was saying, like, my father had servants, they had everything. So he came to his sense. Until we come to our sense, we cannot make a decision. Am I correct? We have to come to our sense where we are, where we've fallen from, how far we've gone from God. Then only we can make a decision. So he came to his sense. The lost sense, he came back to it. He did accept his position, and he doesn't want to play church anymore. And he said, Daddy, I have sinned. So if you come to that place, the next step God will take you to, he made a decision. So now he come to his sense and he confessed to God and he said, God, I'm going to go back to my daddy. And he said, I sinned against my dad. And he made a decision. Verse 18. Can somebody read verse 18? Same chapter, Luke 15.
I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you.
So he got up from his position. First he came to sense. The second one, he got up from his position. See, sometimes, like, people can take you to church. They can pick you up. They can drop you. you can come and sit at God's presence. It's your decision to get up from your position. You can come and still sit in the church, but spiritually you can't be at the same place. So it's you who can make a decision. Or pastor, or elders, or somebody who preach here, they cannot make a decision. It's a personal decision. You get up from your position. The third one, he started to confess. Read verse 19.
I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.
So he started to confess. He's saying, I'm not worthy, Lord. Last week, pastor was preaching about the Pharisees and Levites. These two people went to church. One of them saying, like, I do this in the church. I put it in a nowadays situation. You might say, oh, I come, I do all the work in the church, I'm praising you, I'm praying, I'm playing instruments and doing everything. The other person said, I don't do anything, I'm not worthy. God, I'm not worthy to be anything. But God answered whose prayer, you think? The person who's humble himself and say, God, please help me. When we ask God to help, then he will offer. Then fourth part is, he started to walk toward God. Verse 20, please.
So he got up and went to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion for him. He ran to his son, threw his arms around him and kissed him.
See? Until he made a decision to move towards him, God didn't do anything. I asked God why. He said, when we were lost, he came to us. Then he brought us to the church. Then the second parable talks about he wants us to make a decision and he wants us to receive the word and change our life every day. If we missed it, we're going to go as a prodigal son. When we go to that level, God never comes after us. He waits. So he waits until we turn back to him. Then when he turned back, the verse 20 said, and he arose and came to his father, but when he was yet a great way off, like he didn't come close to him, but when he made a decision to walk towards God, his father saw him and he had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. The son didn't fell on father's neck. If you read it, it's father fell on the son's neck. And he kissed him. Son didn't kiss him first. He shows he's accepting him. It doesn't matter where you are, God will accept you. Today you make a decision. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight. And I am no more worthy to be called thy son. Because he lost the sonship. So he's confessing, God, I'm no more worthy to call myself as your son. Then look at the answer of the father. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe and put it on him and put a ring on his hand and the shoes on his feet. So he tried to restore the son. He's trying to show the son. I remember when back home, my dad is like very hot-tempered person. He's very loving. He will do anything to us. He did a lot of stuff to us as a children. We lack nothing in our life, but when he get angry, he will give us left and right. And by the time he finished and we will cry and everything, after that, like aftermath, after everything finished, he comes from work, that day you will be treated like a queen or king. Because he regret like he beat us up, but we need it, that's fine. But he couldn't control, he will knock us off and then I think he regrets. The same way, so he waited for the son to come back home. When the son came back home, he said, okay, give him a good robe. Because I think he was sleeping with the pigs and he was eating and he didn't take a bath. I think he's trying to put him back in his shape. He said, give him a robe, give him everything, ring. Maybe he sold his ring too. And ring means the authority. He gave back the authority. The robe means the righteousness. He gave his righteousness back because he have to stand next to him as a right standing with God, right? So he gave him everything and the shoes. Shoes is your salvation. If you lose your authority, salvation, and your righteousness, God is ready to give it today. At the end of the thing, we're going to pray. God is ready to, you don't go back as the way you came in. And the second one, then the, everything happened. They bring Hider, the fatted calf, and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. There was a feast. There was a party going on. The next verse say, for this my son was, father was confessing, my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And they began to be merry. So he was, father was so happy, he started to talk and he's saying like, my son was dead, now he's alive. And he started to have a party. For this month, after that, this is the part, it's really usually this message people preach as a prodigal son. But the next part, now his elder son was in the field. And as he came and drew nigh to the house, he heard music and dancing. The other son is still serving God in the church. So he was in the field. Field mean the church. He was serving God, and he heard there's a party going on. He asked the servants what's going on. And he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said unto him, thy brother is come, and thy father hath killed the fatted calf, and he hath received him safe and sound. So imagine this person serving God, and the next verse said, he was angry and would not go in. Therefore came his father out and entreated him. Now, we all think about the younger son went far and he repented and came. There is some of us, you might sit in the church, you might be thinking, oh, that person doing this and this person doing that. But when God tried to bless the younger son, the big one was getting, the elder son got angry. Who need help now? The younger son or elder son? Come on, somebody speak. Who need help? Huh? Elder son need help. Because younger son repented and he's with God. He got everything back, but he lost. But the elder son complaining. So he's angry and jealous. And he's saying, God, see, answering, he started to talk back to God too. How many of you talk back to God? I did. And he answering said to his father, lo, these many years do I serve thee, neither transgress I at any time thy commandments, and yet thou never gavest me the kid. Kid is a baby cow. That I might make merry with my friends. He was complaining. You never gave me anything. I'm coming, I'm doing everything, I'm praying, I'm asking you to do this to me. How many years? 20 years, 22 years, I'm asking. One thing I'm asking, and you never gave me. But somebody who just came, they lived a life, but the way they want, and they came back, and you blessed them and gave them everything. How many of you talk like that to God? Don't lie. Yes, somebody raised the hand. Yes, they're honest. So, like, it's kind of like we always judge other people, right? We started to judge them and say, oh, look at them. They got blessed. Maybe the enemy blessing them? Yeah, they said that word too, I heard. But as soon as this thy son was come, which hath devoured thy living with harlots, harlots with prostitutes, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf. So you made a feast for the son who gone away. And he said unto him, son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine. God is saying, everything, every promise I have in this book, it's yours. Why are you complaining? And the next verse says, it was meet that we should make merry and be glad. For this thy brother was dead and is alive again and was lost and is found. Father didn't search him, but he was checking and waiting for his son to come back. So if you are in a position, the first position God brought you to the church, if you're in the church, the second parable talks about, it's not for me, all the words come, it's somebody else, I know their personal life, it's for them. If you're judging, today you make a decision, every day you come and ask God, please speak to me. The third parable talks about the son gone far, and he came back, what father did. If you've gone far from God, come back today before the door of grace closed. Can somebody read James chapter 1, verse 6, 7, and 8? Then I'm going to close. James chapter 1, verse 6, 7, 8.
Let him ask him saying, nothing wavereth. He that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. Let not that man think that he can receive anything of the Lord. Double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
Yeah, God hates the double-minded people. If you're with God, make up your mind. If your prayers is not get answered, tell God, thank you for your time. If you think nothing changed in your life, say, God, still I'm going to praise you. While you're praising God, he will bring the breakthrough. Sometimes it takes time. It's not your time. God, it's up to God's calendar. We shouldn't get tired of what we are doing, and we should praise him, and he will answer our prayers. Please stand to your feet. As you stand to your feet, I want everyone to close your eyes. I don't want anyone to look here and there. I want you to ask some questions. Quietly stand. Check yourself out all these questions. Who am I? Am I what I do or what I achieved? Maybe you are thinking to achieve the honor student, MPP, champion. You name all the titles you can go. Am I thing I have done right? Am I the thing I have done wrong? Am I a saint? Am I a sinner? What about others think of me? Am I all of these things? Or am I none of these things? Who am I? How my identity, how your identity yourself, identify yourself, determines your life. It's all you. Everyone here, you, how you identify yourself. Sometimes you think like you are not worth anything. But you have to find your manual. It's the Bible. The Bible says about you. It talks about you. If you are what you do, you always have to do more, achieve more to find your value. If you are what others say, you tired to please people instead of your Heavenly Father. But you listen to God, who you are, and embrace His identity in you. You will find freedom to live all His plans for you. He called you His child. He said, you are wise and restored. And you are brand new creation in Christ. You are chosen, holy, blameless before God. He called you His masterpiece. You are loved by God. He made you complete when you believe what God says about you. You walk with confidence. If you think you made a mistake, I'll open the altar. You come, I'll ask Pastor to pray for you. Don't look at other people. I told you, I made so many mistakes.